Hello buddies, how are you doing? I'm doing pretty well, and today I came up with a super duper lesson for you network and security engineers out there. I would recommend you to watch this video till the end, because I'm damn sure you're going to get bunch of takeaways from this video. When network engineers do plenty of configuration works, it is usual to commit mistakes, the configuration mistakes, but such small mistakes can cause nightmares to the whole network, including the people who are using, of course. Today, I'm going to explain one of such mistakes and how a hacker can capitalize those mistakes and cause some massive trouble. Okay, it is time to introduce the network. So this is the simple network I'm going to work with. Consider this network as an internet. So this network is directly connected with the internet, and of course my attacking machine is connected with this network, and my internal network edge router is connected with this network too. So consider this cloud as an internet, and bottom of this edge router I just brought a switch, network switch. It is a simple layer 2 switch, and I connected two endpoints with this layer 2 switch. And this is the internal network. DHCP service is running on this router. So this router is supplying IP address for my entire network endpoints. So these two endpoints getting IP from this router. And the attacker machine is kali-linux, and the first endpoint user PC, it is a simple endpoint with basic network utilities like ping, trace route. We cannot do anything more than that. And this is the web client. So in my previous video I explained how to bring a Docker instance, a Docker machine into your lab. So by using that, I just enabled a Chrome Docker instance. So this is just a web browser. At the beginning of this video, I said a hacker can capitalize your mistakes. And let me reveal what is the mistake. It is on the switch. The mistake is simple. I haven't configured anything on this switch, which means all the network ports are in same VLAN. The default VLAN number 1. Usually you should not keep any ports on a default VLAN, but I kept every port on this VLAN, but I'm going to pay for that. Apart from the configuration mistake, it is mandatory to save the network devices from the external access. I mean unauthorized access. That is the second mistake you shouldn't commit. But unfortunately, in my network, I did both of the mistakes. All the physical switch ports are in the same VLAN, default VLAN, which shouldn't be. And the physical security. I am going to connect my attacker machine with one of the switch ports. I got the access to the vulnerable switch. So from my attacking machine, I can cause any kind of trouble. Here is my attacker machine. It is a simple Linux machine, and I pulled this Kali machine from the Docker hub. So this is the command. This is the official Kali image. I pulled it. Initially, I didn't have a GUI to interact with. Later, I installed xfce desktop. Xfce is graphical user interface for Kali Linux, and I installed it in this machine. And in order to open it, I installed an application called xrdp. So I'm going to trigger the xrdp to open my xfce GUI. So it will be opened through remote desktop protocol. So let me explain that. So when I put list You can see xrdp here. I'm going to initialize now. xrdp, let's see the status first. The xrdp session is running. You can either start, stop, or restart this by using this command. You may not understand when I am saying this Kali installation steps orally, but don't worry, I'm going to put all these commands in the comment section and description, so you can refer that. Now all I need to do is open the RDP. Let's find the IP address first. We need to assign the IP address for Ethernet 2. By default, my attacker machine learned IP address from this network. So the default gateway is pointed to this PC network, and my Ethernet 2 interface is connected with the internal network. So I want to configure IP address on this ETH2 interface only. The ETH1 interface learned IP address dynamically. So this is my lab network. And ETH2 interface is currently without any IP address. I have to configure the IP address manually. And the command is super simple. ifconfig the interface name and the IP address. Finally, the mask. Simple. Now let's verify it. The IP address has been configured. Let's ping the gateway. Yes, the gateway is reachable now from the attacker machine. Now the attacker machine yearned the connectivity for both management and internet, also to the internal network, I mean the target network. This is the edge router running the DHCP service, and the default gateway IP address is 10.1.1.1. So let me make sure the attacker machine is able to ping the DHCP server. Yes, it's happening. Get the GUI of Kali machine. So I'm using the ETH1, the management network, to get the GUI. In order to get that, let's make sure whether the XRDP is running or not. CD, let's see. init.d. This is the folder where xrdp application is running. So here it is, xrdp status. Now the xrdp is not running. Have to initiate that. Okay, now the XRDP session is initiated after I restart the process. Actually, the XRDP is used to take the control of GUI by using the remote desktop protocol. So let's do it. This is my management IP. Here we go, the beautiful Kali window. Let's open the terminal. The best practice. Update the references. I said you before, my edge router is running DHCP services. So let's verify it. So far, no bindings, no DHCP bindings, no leases. Total available addresses 254, and so far no address leased. As the attacker got access to our network from this attacker machine, they can trouble this DHCP. So as a first attack, I'm going to demonstrate the DHCP attack. Now, in order to unleash attack on the DHCP service in the network, I'm going to use a tool called Yersinia. So to open the Yersinia, you can use the help utility and G-G will enable the graphical mode of Yersinia. So I am exactly going to do that. Spelling mistake. Here we go. Yes. Alpha version. It is time to unleash the attack on the DHCP server. Let's do it now. So before unleashing the attack, you have to set up the interface. On which interface you are going to enable the attack. So here, Ethernet 2. So on Ethernet 2 only, I am going to interact with the target network. So the interface is set now. Launch attack. I am going to launch attacks on DHCP. You can also unleash attack on various layer 2 protocols. So the Yersinia tool is exclusively designed for layer 2 protocol attacks. So here I'm going to use DHCP. So in DHCP, let me choose sending discover packet. So when I choose this, what it will do? The attacker machine will generate random DHCP discover packets, and it is going to flood those discover packets through my target network. I already set the interface. Now it is time to unleash the attack. Let's do it. Sending discover packet. See the count, the packets, the number of packets it is generating and flooding it to my target network. It is drastically getting increased, and enormous packets are generated and flowing through the network. Let me check the status of the server. The edge router. Wow, you can see this. The router is getting rebooted. Actually, I'm overwhelming this DHCP server from my attacking machine. So every second, the packet count is drastically getting increasing. You can see here. Let's check the DHCP pool. You can see all the IP addresses in the pool are now assigned a spoofed MAC address. The pool is completely exhausted. What will happen when I turn on a legitimate device and try to fetch the IP address from the DHCP server? And obviously it won't get any IP address. The DHCP pool is completely exhausted. The stats showing this. Total addresses are 254 and leased addresses are 253. Actually, the pool is completely exhausted. It is exhausted by the attacking machine. Now, let me turn on a legitimate PC and try to fetch the IP address. Hopefully, I will not get the IP address for this legitimate device. The PC is started. It requests for the It requests for the IP address. It looks for the DHCP server in the network. Can't find the DHCP server. Now let's stop this attack. When you click list attacks, it will list the number of attacks currently in process. So I stopped it. I just demonstrated this DHCP exhaustion attack with a small network. Just assume you are running an enterprise network and you are having central DHCP server. When you make a configuration mistake or you fail to protect your network devices physically, an attacker gained access to your network, what happened? You will be in deep trouble. The network will completely take over by the hacker. They can do anything they want. Apart from causing the denial of service attacks, they can also be man in the middle for your critical network traffic. Let me show you. Before I explain the man in the middle, let's briefly see about the basic ARP request and response process. Just assume I am just now turning on this user PC and assume a normal situation. There is no attacker machine. Ignore this attacker machine. And just now turned on the user PC. My DHCP server is running and the user PC received IP address from the DHCP server. But after receiving the IP address, when you are initializing any traffic to reach the internet, obviously your device has to send the traffic to your default gateway. But the device knows the default gateway through the DHCP update. In DHCP update, the DHCP server provides the default gateway IP address as well. But it knows the IP address, but it doesn't know what is the physical, what is the MAC address of your default gateway. So in order to find the hardware address of your default gateway, what it does, it simply sends the ARP request through its interface. When it reaches the switch, since the switch MAC address is fresh and doesn't contain any MAC table entries, it also, even the switch also doesn't know where to send. So what it does, it simply forwards the ARP request through all of its interfaces. But when the ARP request reaches the edge router, the edge router realizes the destination IP is its own IP address, and it has to forward the response for that request. In that case, it will replace the destination MAC address with its own MAC address and sends the response to the user PC. So this is how the basic ARP function works. But the attacker can capitalize this ARP request and ARP reply function. Let me tell you the attacker scenario. This time, assume your network with attacker machine. The attacker machine already enabled the ARP attack. Now, when your PC is trying to get the ARP response, it will forward the ARP request. So the switch will forward it through all the interfaces. When the attacker machine receives that ARP request, it will simply respond to that ARP request. Though this attacker machine is not the legitimate default gateway. So obviously what happens, the user PC will receive response from the edge router and attacker machine. Though the attacker machine doesn't receive any ARP request, it can simply broadcast the ARP response through the network, which is simply called gratuitous ARP. So what happens, the user PC will form the ARP table and it forms the ARP table with the attacker machine's MAC address rather than mapping it with legitimate default gateway's MAC address. So what happens in a network when you want to forward a frame or packet to a proper destination, it will always see the hardware address. Based on the hardware address only, it will deliver the packets to the correct destination. So in this case, when the user PC is trying to communicate the gateway, it will simply forward all the packets to the attacker machine. Now the scenario is like, attacker machine and the network. So when the user PC tries to communicate, the attacker machine acting as a gateway. So through this attacker machine only, it will forward all the traffic. In this case, the default gateway for the attacker machine is my direct lab internet connected cloud. So in this case, it will forward it through the lab internet connected cloud, but usually it will forward it through the legitimate edge network device. So what happens here, you can mention the router. So now my attacker machine is acting as a man in the middle. So this is what called man in the middle, and the method used by the attacker to attain the man in the middle position is called ARP poisoning. They used ARP request to attain this position. Enough explaining the theoretical part. Let me show you this practically in this lab. We have another exclusive tool called Ettercap in Kali Linux. I'm going to use the tool to unleash the ARP poisoning attacks. Time to spin up the Ettercap. Like Yersinia, we can open Ettercap also in GUI mode. This is the user interface. Let's set the interface. It is ETH2. I set the interface now. Now it started sniffing through the interface. ETH2 and ETH2 MAC address and ETH2 IP address. I'm turning on both the endpoints now. IP DHCP. DORA process is completed. It received the IP address 10.1.1.145. 144 is assigned to web client and 145 assigned to user PC. Let's verify the ARP table. No traffic initiated from this virtual PC. So the ARP table is empty. Even the virtual PC has no ARP entry for its default gateway. It is time to initialize the ARP poisoning. Before doing that, in Ettercap, you have to set the target. I'm scanning the network. It found two hosts in the network. See the host list. It found three hosts including the gateway, but we have to consider only two endpoints. So add this into a target. Now I added both the hosts into target one. So this is my current target. let's decide what kind of attack we are going to unleash. I'm going to poison the ARP, sniff remote connections. I'm just keeping it as default and giving OK. Now the ARP poisoning victims, all two endpoints are my victims now. Just know the MAC address of this default gateway is ends with 02 and 01. So I'm pinging it. See the ARP table here. The MAC address is different. The ARP entry is different. This is not the MAC address of the default gateway. This is the MAC address of my Kali machine. 050022, it ends with. So what it does, the virtual PC is forwarding all the traffic through my attacking machine. So what happens? The user PC forwards it to the attacker machine, and attacker machine's default gateway is the internet cloud, and it forwards through this cloud. So the target will not reach the edge router. So I'm going to verify that. For that, I need to initiate the capture. I'm going to capture it via Ethernet 2. Filter ICMP. Here we go. The ICMP traffic initiated from my victim machine to the destination. Whatever the traffic initiated by these endpoints now will be flowing through the attacker machine. Let's verify with the web client. The web client is connected now. Let's change the filter. I'm going to filter the destination, the IP address of one of my favorite YouTubers' website, networkchuck.com. Done. There are some latency even to load the Google because it crosses my lab network devices. The page is loading finally. Eventually, when I see the capture, I can see I'm getting bunch of hits. So I'm trying from this web client. It actually passes its traffic through the attacker machine. So that is why I'm able to capture all the traffics here over this interface. Yes, it loaded finally. And I also sniffed the traffic. I'm done with the attack. So I'm stopping this sniffing and the man in the middle things. After stopping the Ettercap, subsequently the ARP entry got changed. Now the ARP is learning properly. This is the MAC address of the edge router's GIG 0/1 interface. The concept I just explained is just part one. In networks, we have few other features to prevent these attacks. The features like DHCP snooping, dynamic ARP inspection. So I'll explain these prevention topics in my part two video. And yes, that's all I've got. I hope you really enjoyed this video. If you learned something from this video, don't forget to like this video and share it with your friends. And just do all those YouTube protocols, commenting, subscribing, everything. And yeah, I'll catch you up with another exciting video. Until then, see you and take care.